Victor McNamara, as well known as Max Lottery, and we are here in Austin to make an interview to my friend Shadow from Black Altar and Offermod, because they will be touring South America. So, how are you, Darius?
I'm fine, thank you. Very cold, because we are outside during the winter, but yeah, we will survive.
Yeah. Thank you. So please introduce yourself to the audience.
Yeah, so as you mentioned, my name is Darius, known on the black metal scene as Shadow. I'm the founder of Black Altar Band and Odium Records. I also play in Offermod, the band from Sweden. And I'm the singer of the new atmospheric band, black metal band called Hill. I have been on the black metal scene almost 30 years.
So you will be touring South America. I'm very curious about what do you think about this continent. Thomas Seltzer, in his documentary on Mexico, called it South America, the continent of tears, and I'm Chilean. So, do you have some background about the history of South America?
Unfortunately,
I don't know too much about the history of South America. Of course, I know that you were conquered by Spain and Portugal, and you had some difficult moments, like Poland. I also know that in South America you have the craziest fans in the world, and I expect total madness on stage during our gigs.
Okay, next question. This is very interesting. It's related with this connection between musical scenes from different continents. Did you know that the Mayhem sound is highly influenced by Colombian bands like Reencarnación and Massacre? Because Euronymous, he was pissed off of the direction, mainstream direction that metal was taking back in the 90s.
I remember that Euronymous was a big fan of the South America scene. For sure, bands from South America like Sarcophago, Sepultura, Massacre or Mystifier were a big influence for many bands. And in each South American country, they have plenty of very good bands, very devoted to the core of true metal and occultism.
Unfortunately,
many of them are underrated and they deserve to be more well known.
Yeah, that's true. Next question. So you will be doing your first shows with Black Altar, that's true?
Yes, exactly.
And you will be touring with, playing along with Offermod too, and you have former guitar player from Behemoth. So can you tell us, please? All these situations that are happening with your band and these activities?
Sure. So when I joined Offermod, I took the whole lineup of Black Altar with me. So we will play the shows with two bands each evening. It will be something new and special for me, because I played the first ever show with Black Altar just 4 months ago. And till now I rejected all offers for a concert during the previous 26 years, and finally I decided to play not too long ago. I gathered together a very good lineup, including ex-member of Behemoth from the first era, as you mentioned already.
Yep.
So before the South American tour, we are going to play just one gig at Brain Crusher from Hell festival in Germany. It'll be our first gig with Offermod with my lineup, and second ever gig of Black Altar. To be honest, I don't know what to expect from the Offermod gigs, but I have a feeling that it'll be total madness on stage and something really special.
So you have Black Altar since many years. What is your main motive? What do you want to express with Black Altar to the audience?
Yes, Black Altar has existed since 96, the same as Offermod, and my goal was and still is to play extreme black metal and spread the pizza ideology worldwide. This year we will record the first full-length album after 16 years and after many splits.
Shadow, besides Black Altar and Offermuth, you are running a label called Odium. You are pretty busy in the underground. Can you tell us about it?
Generally, I'm very busy. It takes about 14-16 hours per day for all of my metal tasks to achieve. But I love it, of course, and yes, I have run Odium Records for about 26 years, and I released many interesting records during that time by bands like Varathron, Vulture Lord, Beastcraft, Graveland, Mephorash, or Vincent Crowley.
Unfortunately,
it takes a lot of time, money, and effort, but as I said, I love it.
Me as a Chilean, I was pretty curious about the Polish metal scene back in the end of the 90s and beginning of the 2000s. You as a band, can you tell us what was the cause for this major metal manifestation happening here in Poland? Because I think, in my opinion, it's one of the most, it's the most strongest Eastern country in metal, and it's very well known scene internationally.
Yes, exactly. The old Polish black metal scene in the 90s was very, very serious and radical, often connected with National Socialism. It was very authentic, and I think that those factors plus quite original music made the Polish scene one of the most important and respected scenes in the world.
Shadow, please tell us your final words for this interview and today's your audience there in South America.
I want to invite all of you to our upcoming tour in South America. You will witness draconian rituals on stage. The great dragon blesses, and see you soon.